Hello everyone, welcome back to Learn for Tricky. I hope you are doing good. In this video, we are going to cover up how to install or how to set up multiple Python version in your Linux machine and switch among them, and also how to create virtual environment using VENV. Okay, so let's get started. So you are able to see that I have PYENV opened on the left hand side and VENV on the right hand side on the screen, right? What PYENV does, it is a shell script which is used to install multiple Python version in a system, and we can switch among them based on our need, because there are cases where you need to run certain things with a different version of Python. Maybe something runs on Python 3.11, something runs on Python 3.3. So you have flavors of both and you can simply switch using the PYENV. Now, secondly, you may need to have multiple virtual environment, means you have multiple project and each of these project has their own dependencies requirement. And instead of installing those dependencies at the operating system level at the global space, we can make use of VENV, which is bundled within Python 3.3 and above to create virtual environment. Prior to Python 3.3, we were having virtual ENV tool that we normally use to create virtual environment. Then the Conda came in picture. So we have seen the Conda in the last video, and also VENV is an approach by which we can create virtual environment. So let's get on the VS Code and see how we can install PYENV and how to use it in order to create a project. So I have with me a VS Code open already. In this, I have created a PYENV nodes. This is basically nodes. And on the start of it, you can follow this along with me, that installation of PYENV in Linux. In order to install PYENV, it is not necessary to have Python in your system, because it is simply a shell script that gets installed into your system with these commands, line number 3 and 4. We simply clone it and then make it. And then we have to set the path using line 6 to 18. We need to run these commands, echo commands, to set the path in bash rc profile and bash profile, so that whenever you open up the terminal, you have PYENV in your terminal. So let's get on the terminal to see how we can use PYENV. As soon as you installed with PYENV, what happened? It creates a .pyenv folder in your home directory. Let me show you. PWD, I have .pyenv in the home directory. Now, what is the content of .pyenv? Let us see. So this is the content of .pyenv. Don't have to look up on a lot of things here. What is important is versions folder, in which whenever you install Python version, that or everything related to that Python will get installed into this versions folder. It will not pollute your global namespace, or it will not globally install anything. You just have to check this folder to check what is installed over there. Okay, and it also contains the site packages folder within that Python version. So whenever you install any dependencies, it will get installed in this particular folder. Okay, so that's the only main folder that you have to worry about, or you can look up. Okay, now let us run few commands. Let me clear the screen. PYENV, what is the version of PYENV I have installed on my system, which is most latest? You can install any stable version. So let us run few commands to check what versions of Python I have in my system. PYENV versions commands without dash dash, and it is shown 3.11.10 is and 3.12.6 is present within my system with the help of PYENV. So, and 3.12.6 is with a star. It means it is selected by default. Whenever I open a terminal, it shows me the version. So if I type in Python version command, so it shows 3.12.6 because it is default set by me. If I set this 3.11.10, so it will show that particular version. So PYENV command to set. So what I do, PYENV local 3.11.10, enter. It selected 3.11.10 by default. Now if I run the Python version again, 3.11.10 is selected. Now you can make use of, whenever you run the Python command, it will make use of 3.11.10 only. You don't have to worry about anything. If you install anything, like you install with the help of pip command or something else, it will not pollute anywhere. It will simply install in the versions directory. So here, if you can see that 3.11.10 is selected. Okay, so If I clear my screen, if you want to install something new, what you can do, you don't have to worry that which folder you are part of or where you are setting. You just have to type in PYENV install. Suppose I want to install 3.11.4, it will simply be downloading that 3.11.4 package and install it within the versions folder. It creates another folder within the versions folder with the name 3.11.4 and download that particular Python in that particular folder. Okay, and then you just have to select that particular version to use it. Otherwise, it will simply be showing over the versions output. Now 3.11.4 is installed. If I check PYENV versions command, you see 3.11.4 is installed. Now it is not selected. To select it, PYENV local 3.11.4. It got selected. Again, check the versions. This is the current selected 3.11.4. Now whatever you type in with the pip, etc., it will get installed within 3.11.4. Now let us get on the VS Code to make use of it as well. Now in the VS Code was already open because in the parallel. But if I type in this command Python version, you may not be able to see 3.11.4 here. It is already showing 3.12.6, which is the existing one. Why? Because there is an option in the VS Code to select a Python interpreter. So here 3.12.6 is already selected. In order to change that, you just have to type in Control Shift P to come up with this dropdown. Select interpreter. If this option is not visible because it is recently used by me, it is shown on the top. So I can type in select interpreter. So similarly, you can do as well. And if you click on the select interpreter, you will get a versions, lot of Python versions in your system basis on PYENV or Conda or something like that. I already have Conda in my system along with PYENV. So that's why both the versions are being visible. Don't worry about that. Choose the version that you have installed recently. So this is the one. 3.11.4.pyenv versions 3.11.4 bin Python. Select this version and you have to just open this terminal again. Close this, open the terminal again. You will be able to see the version of Python is now 3.11.4. Now you are good to use it. Now in order to use it, that I have created a small project with the name main.py is a small file which simply fetching the IP address of my system from the network with the help of request package. Since this request package is not installed by me anyhow, so it shows me the squiggly line with the yellow squiggly line, and it basically fails to run, right? If I tries to run, like get into this sample project folder, and if I type in Python main.py, it says, hey, request package is not available. What shall I do? Now, in order to get this done, I can install this request package at global space. Basically, I can do pip install request. When I do this, it will install the request package within the versions directory 3.11.4. There, it will install request package. Now, this installation is known as global installation. Basically, every time it installs at the Python level. Okay. Now, in order to avoid that, because you might be working with more than one project, right? So you might create an environment. You might need to create an environment specific to that project. So instead of installing like this, I would recommend that you make use of the VENV tool that is packaged with Python. Since I've already installed Python, it has VENV already present. So what shall we do? We have to create the virtual environment. Now, how can I create the virtual environment? Python -m venv and the environment name or a folder name. Think of it, we are creating a separate folder in this directory, in the sample project directory, and everything that we install with the pip install command will get installed into this project directory, not the Python directory. That is, so we are free from those global issues. Now as soon as I type in, what happened? It creates a myenv folder at the sample project level, and over there it has installed a basic structure. Okay, it has installed what is necessary for this environment. Okay, now if I do, like, we have to first of all activate this environment. This command is not activating this environment. there are two steps to virtual environment. First, creating a virtual environment. Second, activating the virtual environment. In order to activate this virtual environment, what we need to do, you have to type in source. I hope it is visible to you. Just source, select my dot slash myenv, the folder that slash bin slash activate. This command you have to type in order to activate. Activate means whenever you type in pip install, it will install everything within this folder only. So for getting this done, we have to activate it first. Source dot slash myenv slash bin slash activate and hit enter. Now this environment is activated. Whenever this environment is activated, you are able to see in this bracket that environment name. It means but whatever command right now I am typing in pip install request, it will get installed over here in this directory, lib directory. Okay, you see there is no request package as of now. Okay, now if I type in pip install request, okay, which is necessary for this program to run, close this. Now it has installed the request package. You are able to see the request package is installed within this folder only instead of installing it at the PYENV level. Okay, now let me clear this terminal screen. Now the squiggly line still is showing up. Okay, in order to get rid of this, now we have created the virtual environment, we activated the virtual environment on the terminal, we installed the request package, but still the VS Code is not happy. To make it happy, we need to tell VS Code, hey, use this virtual environment. Okay, for that you just have to type in again Control Shift P and you have to select the environment. Okay, this is the one, Python 3.11.4 myenv. You just like to select the this virtual environment. You have to select myenv sample project bin python. Okay, now I have selected this virtual environment from the VS Code. Now VS Code knows about it that I have to use everything from this myenv folder, then I'm good. So you see the error gone away. Now if I run this again, will work smoothly. So what to do to run it, and run it with this command python main.py. I hope it should work. See, it works. The IP address is printed here. We have seen it running with the help of Python command. If we want to run it with the help of VS Code, we can simply or debug the code with the help of VS Code. Put the breakpoint here, go over there, run and debug, and you will be able to see the breakpoint hit, and I can do the step over here, and ultimately it will show me the output. Likewise, so in this way we have set up Python environment with the help of PYENV plus VENV and created a small application or small program with the help of this setup. Okay, likewise you can create or you can make use of it in different projects. So yeah, would recommend to use PYENV plus VENV wherever you want to run Python code. You can also use Conda, or you can also use both together in the system. Whenever you need Conda, you can make use of Conda. You can for creating a virtual environment, or you can make use of VENV for creating a virtual environment. Both of these ways are good enough to continue on your Python programming experience. Okay, I hope you like this video. If you like it, if you want to continue on this series, definitely subscribe to this channel and stay tuned for the new videos. Thank you so much for supporting me, and hope you see in the next video. Bye.